We are back with a very special SGND here in New York with partnership in the Clinton Global Initiative. We're talking about how to invest in babies' minds, how to make sure every child has a real shot at success. I want to ask about a slightly different topic, though. Have you guys heard of the marshmallow test?
Yes.
So the basic premise is these are preschoolers, and they're put into a room, and there's a marshmallow there. Mm-hmm. And they're basically told, look, if you wait 15 minutes, no one else is in the room, you wait 15 minutes and don't eat that marshmallow, we'll give you two marshmallows instead. That was basically, and they wanted to see what the kids would do. And they found that the kids who waited tended to do better overall in life. They were more likely to go to college, they were more likely to have successful careers. And it was this concept of self-control. And self-control is something that Sesame Street tries to do as well, as something they try to teach. And for those who don't have young children in the house anymore, I want to play a short clip that I thought was hilarious to remind people just a little bit about what their work is about.
Sure, that's cute.
Wait!
Whoa, why me? Why wait?
Because this is the waiting game, and if you wait to eat the cookie until I get back, you get two cookies!
Dum-de-dum-de-dum. Oh, who me kidding? There's no picture of cookie, there's real cookie.
Oh, remember, wow. Good things come to those who wait. Good things come to those who wait.
You won the waiting game!
Longer, do me get three cookies?
No.
Then what me waiting for?
I think the
that's
I like it's well done. And parents do learn something there as well. But can self-control be taught?
Yes, it is taught. Now, when you're talking about executive function, which are those cognitive skills, that underlie your ability to self-regulate, your ability to control your affect, your ability to have focused attention, and more importantly, your ability to shift your attention. So think about these children who have to go from home to school or different contexts. There are different rules and regulations, so you need to be able to know how to behave and process information in these various contexts.
Speaking of self-control, by the way, I think you did a good job with Chelsea. She's not finding out the sex of the baby.
We have shown great executive function.
I think our work here is done. We don't know if you're going to wind up as president. We don't know.
I go from toxic to really.
We don't know if you're running, I think. Do we?
Yeah,
no,
I think that's...
No, it's okay. Right. But we do know you're going to be a grandmother, as you point out.
That is absolutely the case, yes.
Do you think, based on this discussion that we're having, are the things that you think you would do, obviously your role would be different, you'd be a grandmother, not a mother, but do you think you'd do things differently now with this grandchild versus how you helped raise Chelsea?
You know, it's so interesting because on my book tour over the summer, I must have shaken, I don't know, 70,000 hands, and probably more than half of them mentioned something about being a grandparent. And oftentimes it was sort of joking, like, oh, it's so much better than being a parent. You know, if I'd known how good it was, I would have skipped the first part of it. that kind of back and forth. I think that you have just a different perspective, in part because of your time in life and all of that, to enjoy a grandchild. And most of us, when we have our children, you know, we're still younger, we're still striving, we're still preoccupied about what's going to happen in our lives and what the future looks like. And I think a lot of people look back and say, well, you know, I did the best I could, but maybe I could have spent more time, or I wish I had, or I wish I hadn't been so busy, and all the rest of it. And I think being a grandparent, you just have that freedom. Yeah. At least that's what I'm told, and I'm anxious to find out whether that's true, being a member of that club.